Hello everyone, Kayla here. And in today's video, I'm going to be talking about silicones, what they are, why people say they're bad, if they really are bad. You can kind of make that judgment yourself after you have watched this video. So, first thing I want to start off with is what's commonly said. Most people who have curly hair or have kinky, coily hair, natural hair, pretty much believe that silicones are bad for the hair. I have read those exact words on forums, on YouTube comments, everywhere. I've seen silicones are bad. But I am willing to almost bet, because I'm not a gambling woman, almost bet that most of these people that are saying that silicones are bad probably cannot actually produce a answer as to why they're bad. They can't tell you why they're bad. So I want to present some information so that you can decide if they are really bad for you and actually be able to know why they're bad. So silicones, what are they? Silicones are a lot like synthetic oils. Silicones are not something that are naturally occurring in nature. They are definitely man-made, laboratory-made. And it acts a lot like oil, in fact, in the fact that it coats the hair strand. What this coating does is it protects your hair from the outside environment. So if you live in a high humidity area, silicone can kind of slow the effects of the humidity on your hair or prevent the effects of humidity on your hair. Also, the coating can keep your hair from losing moisture very quickly. So sealing things in just like an oil would. The third thing that the coating does is that it's slick. So it causes you to have slip in your hair. And if you're not familiar with what slip means, that just means that you're able to easily glide your fingers through your hair. The strands glide past each other. If you've ever used a silicone containing conditioner, you know what I'm talking about. Osmoist is one that comes to mind. And let me tell you, you can detangle your hair like nobody's business when you use Osmoist conditioner. So the main place where people have an issue with silicones is their removal. There are two different types of silicones. There are water-soluble silicones, ones that can be removed from just rinsing them off, and then there are non-water-soluble silicones, ones that you actually have to shampoo off. Most silicones fall into that second category of needing to be shampooed off. You can 100% guarantee that a sodium lauryl sulfate containing shampoo can definitely remove silicones. It may not be as known, but shampoos that contain gentle cleansers like cocoaminopropyl betaine can also remove silicones. So a lot of your sulfate-free shampoos contain these other cleansers that are actually capable of removing these silicones from your hair. So if you do not use shampoo, you know, silicones can become an issue for you because they can cause buildup. Just like if I was using product on my hair and never removing it, or putting oils on top of oils on my hair and never removing them, it would eventually cause buildup. Buildup on your hair can cause dryness, brittleness, breakage, so on and so forth. Also, dryness of buildup on the hair can also make your hair really frizzy and dull looking as well, so it doesn't look good. And so that's the main issue that people have. People who are following low or no shampoo methods try to avoid silicones, not because the silicone is in and of itself bad, it's because they are not using the methods to properly remove the silicones. However, if you are someone who shampoos their hair, and you know, if you're subscribed to my channel, I am definitely team shampoo, then you don't have to worry about using silicones. Now, I actually tend not to use products with silicones just because there are so many great products now, you know, 2017 modern times, that don't have silicones, and that I've developed favorites and things that I really like that just don't have silicones anyway. So or I use products that have water soluble silicones in them. So it's been a habit for me to use those type of products. But I know that if I do end up using something that has silicones, I'm not worried about it because I shampoo my hair. So what I'm going to do down in the description box is that I'm going to include a link to an article on silicones, so you can see which ones are water soluble, ones that you can just rinse off, and then also ones that need to be removed with a cleanser of some sort. And I think I'll try to, if it's a separate article, because I can't keep them all straight in my mind, link also what types of cleansers outside of the sulfates are able to remove silicones. So I feel like silicones have gotten a bad rap. A lot of people are saying that they're bad, but they don't really know why they think they're bad. There's no like real research happening here. So if you like this video, definitely give it a thumbs up, share it with your natural friends, leave a comment down below, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thanks so much for watching.